Hello everyone, welcome back. I'll be solving most of your questions today regarding the Helidon setup one by one. And before that, I'll just give you a quick introduction about the Helidon MP. So it is a micro profile specification of the Helidon version where you will be getting most of them. Basically the SE plus the more feature will be a Helidon micro profile and maybe kind of a JAX RS version that you know and how to use. You are familiar with all these things when working with web services. So in that cases, I'm happy to announce that Helidon will not be a headache for you. You will be able to grasp all those stuffs very easily. And not much of a thing I have to tell you now for this. And I'll quickly demonstrate how to do it because I know that's why you are here. So for a prerequisite part, I just want to show you a quick thing about the prerequisite. I don't know why it's not working. Let's see. Okay, before it's loading, I'll quickly tell you the prerequisite part that are basically, yeah, it came. So you need to have a Java SE 11 and you need to have Maven and Docker. So but you will install it. What now? Suppose you are doing it for the first time, kind of a new task has been given to you. So you know, right, all those things about the environment variables, right? Environment variable. So you go here, you set up your Java home where your JDK is there, set up your Apache, Maven where your Maven is there. Then go to the path, check on this. You make sure you have all this path after the download part. Okay, you have downloaded Docker, you have downloaded Maven, you have downloaded JDK, you have downloaded Git also, then Windows System 32. Sometimes you will see that the CMD command is not recognized because you don't have the system path set up in your particular machine. So everything is set up for us. We are good to go. And then we will be doing this because the system said so, just to give you a brief overview. And yeah, so I have already set it up, but I'll show you quickly. So we have 14.0 Java version and same will go for Maven. We have Apache Maven, stable version 3.6.3. And then we'll check for Docker. Docker, we will have this version built in 19.03.0.12. And we will also check the Kubernetes version. We will be having the version, but the system has not been properly set up. So that's why the unable to connect to the server is coming up. So we will do it later. But before that, we are having everything set up. So that's a good sign for us. And let's just directly see what to do in the next step. So I went here, I came here, I saw this particular MVN archetype command. So I know that you have tried it maybe and it's not working. It's not working because you have to remove this. Okay. So you have to make it something like this. Where it is? Something like this. Okay. Fully till last. Change the artifact ID to Helidon just for your own convenience. If you want a big name, you can do the big name. It will directly do the basic structure for you. And if you want, I can do it, but I don't think so. You have to do it again. It's very easy. So what I have, you have to do is remove the backslash and front slash, whatever is there. Just pay, keep it all in the first in a text folder and then just paste it up in the particular command prompt. Okay. And then we will be going inside the Helidon where we have installed it. And we have went inside and then we will be doing the MVN package. Okay, so once we do the MVN package, it takes some time. Okay, it takes some couple of time. I think you are doing it for the first time, so hopefully it should complete fast. Oh sorry, I'm doing it for the multiple times. I mean, I have done it, but see, okay, we are done. So package is done. The one which will take time is a application running. So the project builds an application jar, for the example, and saves all the runtime dependency in the target libs directory. This means you can easily start the application by running the application.jar file. But as I told you, I have changed it to Helidon So that for that reason I'll be running this particular thing, and it will take time. Okay, it will take time. So if you see here, we have completed it, and just to see if we have completed it or not, what we will do is I'll quickly show you the one we have to do. We have to see this. Okay, I will run this particular thing, and yeah, we are done. So you want to see some different versions, we can show you here. Just paste it up, and you know how to do curl. Curl I'll not be using it now. I might be making it a different video if suppose you liked it. But yeah, so see, it's very easy for us, and I hope, and let's see what it does. I don't think it will work, but just to hello greeting. Okay, so we have to change the greeting one, something like that here, and this can be done with the curl command where the content type is JSON. So we have completed the CMD part. Later it's a health and all metrics where you can do easily, and I will be making sure that this all things are done. But before that, let's just concentrate on the curl command, and we will be doing the next steps further. But let me just quickly set up the same thing for you in IDE, and then we will be making it in next video. So see what I have to, you have to do is come here, file, okay, and you have to go on import existing Maven project, next, and you have to go on the folder. You will be having this form, and because it's showing me that it's already imported, nothing to do. It's just a one thing you have to do. That's it. There will be some here and there error will be there, and that can be done with Maven itself. Then you go and put it run as, and try to do the clean first, and then you again go here and go to run as and put Maven install. There are test failures showing us because we know what's the error, and we will see the errors were deployment failed to start the web server, because we are already using it here, right? So we have to actually close it. It closed, and then if we run it, I hope this time it gets done fine. See, it's completed now. So yeah, then later if you go to main test, I'll just quickly show what's there. You know that we are seeing the particular greeting provider, right? So there are some default here. Get message, set message, just a simple greeting message provider. This is a resource class, where we have the update greeting, where we are getting the date. I'll just give you the brief format. First, we are instantiating the greeting provider. We are making it as our own, calling it actually. And then we will be doing the injecting functionality where the greeting config is there. This is not particular, not required as of now, but just to make sure. And that is a default. We will be putting the world as a response. And then if we are doing something as a name, like we have put Jose and all those things, we will be getting the response as name. And same thing if we have put some custom greeting like Namaste or something like that, so we will be using the particular update greeting one, like if you have seen this one, right? Accept update greeting Ola and all those things. This is update greeting one, where we are calling the greet underscore greeting, greet forward slash greeting. And this is a create name one, which we have seen it here, custom greeting one. get default message, then there is a get message. Here their name is there, right? Same thing. And that's how it is done. And basically, if you see, everything is provided here. The testing class, JE meeting will be provided. And if you see, logging is provided. You can search more, but first thing is done, that we have actually done it and everything is working fine. Maven dependencies are there, system libraries are there. Docker, we will do it in a later class, so not class video. Till then, stay safe. I hope you liked it. It's a simple installation, but I know where you will stuck. Just get, make sure everything is set up properly in your system. If not, check the environment variable. The forward slashes are the key, and then start with Helldon. We will be coming up with more and more features later in the day. Till then, see you. Stay safe. Bye bye.